So how did what the Stones do compared to like what Paul McCartney does? Now, Paul McCartney's been out playing the same songs with pretty much the same set list for a while with the same band.
Right.
These guys probably that he's playing with right now have played those songs, those Beatles songs, a lot more than the other three Beatles did.
Right.
So how does that differ from what McCartney's approach is to what the Stones' approach is?
Well, McCartney, you know, played an energetic show at Wrigley Field when I saw him a couple of years ago. He's certainly still got it. His voice is in great shape, but it's a different sound. It's a different approach. I mean, these are essentially rock and roll songs in a pop context. Mm-hmm. I mean, you pretty much have the song and you play it pretty much the same way. Each time you play it, there's not a lot of room for variation there. You know, you're not going to get a 32-bar solo instead of the 8-bar solo. With the Stones, there's sort of that give and take, as Keith has said, the ancient art of guitar weaving with him and Ronnie Wood, where things sort of break down and build back up and kind of ebb and flow within the song. So inside of this song that you've heard a million times is a lot of subtle interplay and nuances and changes and improvisation that kind of make it feel a little more fluid and improvisational than, say, a McCartney show would be, which is very much, you know, I've got this very good band and they're going to play these songs this way night after night and you're going to get a very solid show, but you're not going to get, you know, the Stones could be great one night and a train wreck the next, whereas McCartney has got that consistency. But in some ways I prefer what the Stones bring to it, because when you see them on a great night, you know, it can be quite powerful.
Right.